Josh. And today I have a giant inflatable ball. This ball is basically made so you can get inside of it and you can like walk on water or in the pool, whatever you want to do with it really. And that's why I bought it. I didn't buy it for this video. So if we can do 10,000 likes, I would greatly appreciate it because I'm potentially destroying a $200 ball that I didn't want to use for this in the first place. But I think the stuff I had in mind would be really cool for it. So I decided just to go with it. Hopefully it's not broken by the end of this. But anyway, we're gonna go get started on this. I'm not sure exactly what we're doing, but I have a few plans exactly on what we might be doing with it. So let's go get started on that. All right, guys. So right now, this is the box, which is relatively a small box compared to how big this bubble is supposed to be. Hopefully it is. So I'm gonna open this up right now because I'm really curious how it's folded here, to be honest.
Where'd you get that big ass knife from?
It came off Dragon's Breath, the Nerf gun. This is one of the bayonets. I just took it off.
Holy crap. They have counters.
It comes with the freaking leaf blower? Yeah, I almost bought a leaf blower because I thought it didn't come with one, but it came with one. Dope.
The sound of it.
Oh my gosh.
Is this hard to get open too?
Oh, fuck. Yo, right? Holy shit, this thing's heavy. I feel like I'm wrestling with a jellyfish. God, it's hard to breathe. I'm gonna get in there right now.
Go.
Okay. Gotta get in there.
Just lay down. Fruit by the Loop challenge.
And this is what it would have been like if my dad had used the condom.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Dude, it sounds like so trippy in here.
All right, guys, so right now I'm in the bubble and you can hear the echo. That's not any audio problem. This is exactly what I hear. I'm hearing my voice bouncing off all of the different plastic scenes. It's so crazy in here. Like, everything I look out, this is what they look like.
All right, so Marcus is pretty much gonna try to walk over Matthew with in the ball. Oh, we should move that.
Marcus.
We should move that before you pop.
Wait. Alright guys, this is where you can see my perspective of what happens when they jump on it and I jump at the same time. I swear they look like a bird flying into a sliding glass door. Yeah. 3, 2, 1.
Got you.
Oh. Dude, I feel the air, oh my god.
Holy crap, it's like 1,000 degrees. Dude, cause like all your body heat just builds up in there.
It's so hot in
like
there.
That sweat.
It's humid as hell in there.
All right, guys, so what we're planning on doing now is getting this fog machine and me getting inside of there and turning the fog machine on to see if it's like some crazy like fog thing. Nope. Do you think it's fill the whole thing?
I don't think yeah. able to see you.
Do you think it's to fill the whole thing? That's my...
It's gonna be zipped up, obviously, so it's gonna be like...
I feel like it'll be like in a horror film where it's just completely disappear smoke and fog and you go poof to the window and you can see yourself.
Alright guys, so right now we just put the fog machine in here and he's gonna blow it up while I'm in here basically to see if we can even keep the cord for the fog machine in here.
Alright guys.
The person at the store said it's okay to breathe this stuff in, but hopefully they're right. That's what I see now. Ready? 3, 2, 1. Marcus, where are you going?
Is it hard to see me out there?
Oh my god, it's getting harder and harder to see him.
It's really hot in here too. This is my view, guys.
Look like a fucking snowball, dude.
Marcus.
What?
On right here. Do a quick like run up.
Oh shit!
Guys, it literally feels like I'm in a cloud right now. My voice sounds weird because all the moisture in the air. I can't express this. I feel like I've gone to the light. Everywhere I look is just white. It's so crazy in here. I can't tell how far the left is and how far the right is. How far up is, I can't even see the roof right now.
What?
Dude, it seriously looks like
Josh. Pokemon. Come here.
Oh my, dude, on the camera, you look like this one big ass white ball.
It doesn't even look like smoke anymore. It just looks like as if we bought a white ball and you put inside of it.
That's seriously how it looks.
Oh my god! Vape Nation.
Get out of here.
Vape God coming out of my dick.
That's
when you know, that's when you know you're a vape god. When you spew vape.
Dude, you can't see shit. Dude, oh wait, dude, you can't see anything in the house.
I cannot even believe.
You cannot see anything in here.
You can't see anywhere.
I can see Josh. I can see
Reptar. Dude, look, you can't see anywhere past the lights.
That was so much fog. That was ridiculous.
Alright guys, you can still see the fog in the room. We've been waiting for 45 minutes now, and it's still foggy. You're waiting for it to slowly fog out, but it's not quite there yet.
Okay guys, so if you saw the glow stick video, you guys already know that highlighter fluid actually glows under a black light. So my theory is if I get inside there with this bucket, and I splash it all around the inside, I should be able to be inside of a giant glowing bubble once we turn the black lights on. So hopefully this works and I get inside there and a lot of highlighter fumes are gonna be building up in there, but I'm gonna try my best.
Okay, so the bucket is in there ready to be blown up, and right now they're taking the lights out of the regular lights out the studio lights, and I'm opening up these black lights to put inside of there and hopefully should have the same effect that did in the glow stick video.
All right guys, so right now I'm gonna try and spread this all over the bubble.
Oh! Big ass, Shrek buzz a big ass fucking load in there.
Yeah.
Alright,
guys, are we ready?
Alright, I'm ready.
All right. Three, two, one.
That looks so sick. Dude.
What the fuck?
Dude, that looks insane. That looks insane.
What the fuck?
This is my view inside here right now. If I pick up the liquid, this is like I'm in this green slime, and then if I splash it, I just see it going down. And it actually looks better from outside than it does in here. In here, it looks like a bunch of drops. But out there, it looks freaking dope.
I feel like I just got birthed by Reptar.
Dude,
I'm telling you, dude, I feel like I'm Shrek's like fetus. I just got this came out early.
Alright guys, now we're at the beach, as you can see back there, and it's really filthy. This California beach is for you. This is why it's the perfect place to test out the safety bubble. You can be in your own space at the beach. I actually wanted to have a bigger area to test out the bubble pretty much. And we're gonna try and see if we can actually get into the water with the waves pushing us backwards. I'm not sure, I may only get a couple inches into there with the waves pushing me back, or I might get pretty deep in there. We'll find out.
Yeah. No!
Here,
jump and I'll run that way.
There's nothing to it. I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night.
Oh!
Alright guys, I'm in the bubble right now. This is the ocean water below me. That's the waves behind me. This is what my view looks like right now. That's Parker and then down there. This is me right here. That's what our ocean water looks like. It's all green and stuff.
Alright guys, well down there that's the lifeguard.
He just took this out. Which
I guess is understandable because it is kind of a safety hazard, I guess. But we got the footage, I guess that's all that matters.